Good afternoon. Welcome to St. John the Evangelist Church as we observe the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please rise as we begin by singing Holy, Holy, Holy.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May the peace of the Lord Jesus, the love of God, the power of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And welcome to all, especially any guests that join us on this beautiful afternoon. Today's gospel reminds us that in the name of Jesus, great power and healing flows. For the times you have not used the name of God properly, for the times we have sinned, let us prepare our hearts asking forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who founded the salvation of the human race on the incarnation of your word, give us, your people, the mercy they ask, so that all may know there is no other name to be asked but the name of your only begotten Son, Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses. Taking some of the spirit that was on Moses, the Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, "Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp," Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, "Moses, my Lord, stop them." But Moses answered him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets? Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From my unknown faults, the precepts of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth is rotted away, your clothes have become moth-eaten, your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be testimony against you. It will deliver your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasures for the last days. Behold, the witnesses you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud, and the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned, you have murdered the righteous one. He offers no resistance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Speak, O Lord, your servant is listening. You have the words of everlasting life.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen, I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with two feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than with two eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where there worm does not die, and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord. This Friday is the first Friday of the month. It was a great time to attend Mass, to make the first Fridays. It's also the feast of one of the most famous, well-known, most beloved saints throughout the 2,000 years of church history. October 4th is the feast of Saint Francis of Assisi. And while Francis is probably the most beloved, especially in what we call an ecumenical saint, probably even the atheists love Francis because of his love of the earth and his peace and connection with nature. But my favorite Franciscan saint is a contemporary of Francis, and that is Saint Anthony of Padua. He was a tremendous preacher who traveled all over Europe preaching, and wherever he would find himself preaching, if it was on a town square, a church, a cathedral, the places were always jam-packed, thousands and thousands of people. So impressive is his preaching that even after 800 years, some of his homilies are preserved, are written down, and sold to those who desire to read. But one of his homilies was about today's gospel, the very latter part of today's gospel, where Jesus speaks in what we call hyperbole, exaggeration to make a point. And after his homily, he was visited by a mother who was greatly stressed because her son just had cut off his foot and begged Anthony to come to the house and pray with his son and see what he could do. And he went to the house and said, "Why did you cut off your foot?" He says, "Well, you just said in Scripture, if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. And I was so mad at the cow, I just kicked the cow." So there was, before duct tape, Anthony took the foot, put it back on the leg, wrapped it up in rags, clean rags, and prayed for a healing, and eventually the miraculous took place so that the foot again grew back onto the leg. Jesus, by using hyperbole, is reminding us how evil, how horrible, how sinful, how dreadful, how death-giving is sin. And that we really need to eliminate sin and the habit of sin, our the behavior of sin, in order that we may be one with God in a complete, whole way. Throughout life, we are tempted in three different ways, and one of the ways we are tempted is just by our very selves. Sometimes our appetites, the way we are raised, lends us to sin. Maybe if we have missed Milky Ways in our life, our mother never served Milky Ways, we might go to the store and just steal one. That is a temptation that can lead to sin. We know that the world is filled with temptations. The advertisement world might be a source of temptation. Of course, we know that pornography, which is continually directed towards our youth, younger and younger, the pornography industry is continually working that they can sell it on the internet, they can expose it on Facebook, all these chat traps, whatever they're called, sources of sin. That's why it's a good practice if you have children in a computer. It's in a common room where kids are not alone with all this evil device. And of course, Satan himself can be a great source of temptation in our lives. And in the 15 discernment principles offered by Saint Ignatius of Loyola, he says, "Satan is like a general in pursuit. And before he attacks his pursuit, the city, the people, what does he do? He pauses and he studies. And he looks for the weakest link. Where is the easiest way to attack?" And so Satan looks at us all day long. He probably knows us better than we know ourselves. He knows where our weakness is, and that's where he's going to attack. But all this leads us to the very beautiful part of today's gospel. Where this man who's not a follower of Jesus uses Jesus' name. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. And so we have the grace and the power in the name of Jesus that can help prevent us in each one of these situations of temptation. No matter if the temptation is from ourselves or the world or Satan, we can use the name of Jesus to renounce. And there's just a beautiful, simple little formula to pray. In the name of Jesus, I renounce the temptation of jealousy. Fill me, Lord, with the gift of generosity. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I renounce the sin of unforgiveness. Rather, fill me with the gift of compassion. In the name of our Lord Jesus, I renounce the sin of lust. Give me the gift of purity. So here we are using the power of the name of Jesus, just as this man did. And Jesus desires us to use his name often in a very pure and holy way. Many people use Jesus' name in anger and frustration, but Jesus also we can use as a way of healing grace. Just to call upon the name of Jesus to fill us with grace each and every day of our lives. Today's gospel is filled with hyperbole. Pull out your eye, cut off your hand, saw off your foot. Rather, let us use the power and the grace that comes through the name of Jesus to bring healing of our minds and our bodies and in our souls. So let us rise as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. To God who desires to give us the fullness of life on earth and in heaven, we pray our needs in confidence.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Lestecki, and all the baptized, that we may welcome the gifts of the Spirit and be transformed by the Spirit's work in us, so that God's mercy, compassion, and presence may be manifest to our world. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of discipleship, that we may never prefer anything, even our most treasured possessions, to our relationship with Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed sense of mission, that we may each use our unique gifts and opportunities to share God's love through words, deeds of healing, hospitality welcome, or cups of water, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all young people, that God's Spirit will fill them with wisdom and understanding so that they may correctly perceive the values of life and not be seduced by wealth, fame, or power, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all children, particularly those who lack food, homes, or health care, that God will guide us in providing for these little ones, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing and renewal, that the Holy Spirit will bring healing of mind, body, and spirit to all who have experienced abuse. Help their voices to be heard and guide us in supporting them. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, that God will renew the gift of life within them and restore them to activity and health. For Marlene and Gina, and the members of St. John's Parish, for whom this Mass is offered, and for those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Almighty God, in your generosity, you have sent us the gift of your Son, Jesus. May we call upon his name to strengthen us, to fortify us in our needs. We ask this in all our prayers through Christ our risen Lord.
I myself am the bread of life. You and I are the bread of life. Taken and blessed, broken and shared by Christ, that the world might live. Spirit, gift of the Maker's love, and we who share it know that we can be one, a living sign of God in Christ. I myself am the bread of the world might live. Here is God's kingdom given to us as food. This is our body. This is our blood. A living sign of God in Christ. I myself am the bread of life. You and I are the bread of life. shared by Christ, that the world might live, that the world might live, that the world might live.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name for our good and of all his holy church. Bringing you these offerings from what your bounty bestows on us, we pray, Lord, that just as you have given to Christ, obedient even unto death, the name that saves, so you may grant us protection by its power. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and saints, we give you praise.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power,
and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Remember your love.
The Fall 40 Days of Life campaign has begun, and the Wisconsin Life Chain is set for next weekend. Please see the bulletin for more information from the Respect Life Committee. St. John's Boy Scout Troop will be selling Christmas wreaths this weekend after Masses. The Word Among Us for September is available in the narthex. The cost is $2 each, and script will be sold after all Masses this weekend.
Let us pray. Almighty God, may the sacrificial gifts offered to your majesty to honor Christ's name, in which we have now received, fill us with your abundant grace, so that we may come to rejoice that our names too are written in heaven. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of heavenly hosts, by the power of God,
cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Mary, Queen of heaven and earth,
pray for us.
In honor of St. Francis, we'll have the blessing of pets next Saturday at noon over by the St. Francis Shrine. If you'd like to have your pets blessed, please join us at 12 noon. If the weather is rainy, we'll have the blessing in the church hall. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for light. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun.